Yeah, Gulston, both candidates oppose amnesty for those already here illegally, but Poizner takes a harder line than Whitman, saying he wants to wipe out all taxpayer-paid benefits.
Patricia, pasa aquí, por favor.
There is rarely a lull in business at this Catholic Social Services office in Sacramento, where immigrant families were getting help today on matters like taxes and housing.
Take illegal immigration.
Immigration reform has emerged as a hot issue.
Whitman and Barack Obama have the same policy on illegal immigration.
Republican Steve Poizner vowing to crack down on those here illegally by reviving a 16-year-old initiative.
So what I'm talking about is taking Prop 187 and modify it and tweak it, make it legal.
You can make it constitutional?
Sure, you can. And 10 other states have done it.
They keep coming. 2 million illegal immigrants in California.
You may remember Prop 187, pushed by then-Governor Pete Wilson in 1994 to eliminate schooling and other benefits for illegal immigrants. The measure was eventually found by the courts to be unconstitutional. Poizner's idea, say critics, is scapegoating.
What he's proposed is backward-looking and does not look at how we should look forward and build our state.
Like Poizner, Republican Meg Whitman would crack down on employers who knowingly hire illegals, but she does not support eliminating benefits. A new study out today, meantime, indicates those costs may not be as expensive as some think.
We did find something that I think is very interesting, which is that 85% at least of the unauthorized immigrants are paying taxes in advance of actually earning their legal status.
But Poizner believes the burden for schools, for jails, for food stamps is unacceptable. And one of the biggest costs to the state of California is for keeping illegal immigrants in prison or jail. That is nearly $1 billion price tag a year, with only a fraction reimbursed by the federal government. It is an annual gripe coming out of the state capitol.
So it's clear that Poizner's plan here is aimed at core conservative votes.
Sure.
Come this fall, though, how's that going to translate to votes overall in the state of California?
Well, California obviously remains a blue state, heavily Democratic. The Republican Party experienced some notable fallout from this issue back in 1994 from Latino voters, so we could well see much of the same this year.
And Latinos making up more of the vote in every election.
They are voting more actively than ever before.
Yeah, Kevin, thank you.